Okay, hello everyone. My name is Vipin and I work in Red Hat since 8 months. My general task is to test a product which is written in Python. So I use Jenkins to do my regular automation task, and I test that Python code using Jenkins. So I don't have an agenda page, so let me tell you what I'm going to tell you about. I am going to test the Facebook login feature via a Python script, and that script is being executed by Jenkins. So first of all, let me tell you what Jenkins is. So Jenkins is basically a free and open source automation server. It is written in Java, and it is used to do the non-human part of software development lifecycle. When I say non-human part, it means like whenever a new change got merged in the repo, so it will do some task like it will run your automation. It will automatically create the RPM packages and test them. So I am going to tell you how we can use pipeline scripts in Jenkins. So what a pipeline is? A pipeline is basically a set of plugin which is used together to make a robust automation. And I will show you the basic example of testing the login feature of Facebook page. So this is the Python script which I am going to use. So this script is basically going to facebook.com and then putting whatever the username which is passed to the function into that username column, and then password in the password column, and try to login through those username and password. So let me just run this script once. So this is the same script which I am going to use, which is here, and it is in the repo, in this repo as well. This loginfb.py, you will get the repo URL in the presentation. So let me run this script by sending username as user1 and password as pass01. So as the script started, it will print that it will going to test it with this user and this password. It will go to Facebook page. It will put the user1 and the credential which I just gave through the command line, and it click on login button. Let's wait. So if it was login, it was able to login, it will stuck on that page for 9 seconds, which is I have mentioned in the script. But it was not able to login, so it just passed on. So I am going to test this script via Jenkins. So before like going to pipeline script, let me tell you about different type of things we have in Jenkins and why we use pipeline. We will get to that later. So to install or set up Jenkins, you just have to download the jar file which is available on the document. Come on. So this, sorry, not the jar, the jenkins.var file which you will get on the official documentation page of Jenkins. So to run this, you have just to pass this run this command java-jar jenkins.var file and define the port on which you want to run your Jenkins server. So I have started the server on my local host. Let me get there. So it is running. Starting the server. So as the server got started, it will ask you for the login and password, which I have already done that. I click that don't forget me next time on option. So in Jenkins, we basically create jobs. Whatever project we create in Jenkins is called a job. So we have three or four kind of jobs in Jenkins. One is freestyle job. Next is pipeline job, which we are going to discuss right now. Next is a seed job and multi-branch pipeline job. So let me go through the seed job thing. So to create a job, we have basically these options in Jenkins to create a new item. The people can be, so multiple people can work on same Jenkins server. So we are just going to create a new item and name it as test freestyle. So basically we are creating a freestyle project. It means we have to configure things by clicking on the UI page and doing stuff. So as I click on the fill up the name freestyle project and select the OK button, it will take me to the configuration page of that job which I just created. So we have a few sections here in a job. In general section, we have description and we have a lot of options here. Let me discuss a few of them which we are going to use. So this option is parameterized option. This option is used when we want to pass a variable to the script. So as you saw, we run our script by passing the username and the password. So I can't like going to pass my original Facebook password like this in plain text. So I define a variable here and a string type or whatever type kind of variable you want to define. So I'm going to name it as user, and whatever be the value of those variables. So this is the way when how I define variables in Jenkins in a freestyle jobs. So I just click on this parameterize option. I select that I want to define a string type parameter, and I type the name of that variable. I define the value, default value of that variable, and we can perform these options here. So next we have source code management or SCM. Here we can define that before starting the project, you have to like clone this repo or which branch of the repo, these kind of thing we decide in SCM. Next, we have the build trigger option. In build trigger, basically we say that Jenkins that you have to run this job at a specific time. So build after other project, this is used basically as a down, if we want to this project run as a downstream project. So suppose we have a script written that will build the RPM package as a new change merge in the repo. So we can set this job as the downstream project, but as the build available, you have to trigger the job. Next, we have periodically option. So this is like the cron tab in Linux. We define like if we want to run every hour, if we want to run the job every day, alternate days, or once in a month. So here we type that cron job syntax here, and Jenkins will take care of all those things. Next, we have poll SCM. So poll SCM is basically similar to build periodically, but poll SCM will wait if a change occur in the repo, and after change occurs. So suppose I have right here the cron tab of 1 hour. So it will wait if a change got in the repo, and exact after 1 hour it will trigger the jobs. Next, we have build environment options. So environment is nothing. Basically, this is the environment which Jenkins set before running the job. So it can be of like creating your virtual environment, or it will first option which you can see here is like delete the workspace. So what a workspace, let me tell you what workspace is. So workspace is basically nothing. It is a folder which Jenkins create to put all the data of a specific job. So suppose we have this job which we just created, test freestyle. So what Jenkins do is Jenkins create a folder named test freestyle and put all these things. So suppose it will clone the repo and the result which will generated from the actions by running the test. So all these things are put in this folder which Jenkins create, and that folder is called workspace. So we can select this option that if we want to delete the workspace every time before it start the jobs. Next, if we want to use some secret text, as I just mentioned, I'm going to use my Facebook password, so I can't just define them right here in plain text. So what I can do is I can store them in Jenkins credential option. If we go to the home page, we do have a credential section here, and I have added one credential here whose ID is FB, and its description is my Facebook password. From here, you can add the credential. Let me just go to the update tab. So this is the secret text. This is not actually my Facebook password. This is the hash encryption of my Facebook password. It assign a ID to it as FB, and this is the description which I give. So if we want to like set some secret text or some secret username or password, whatever we are going to use in our build, about if stuck is basically nothing. If the job is running from days and days, it's stuck at some point. So here I would like to give example of, suppose we are doing SSH in a machine. So first time if you SSH in a machine, it will ask you to store the fingerprint thing. It will ask you to enter yes or no. So you can't just go into the mid of automation and enter yes or no. So job will get stuck there. So you can set time out here that at a particular time, if the job won't run, just abort that job. Next is timestamp is nothing. It basically attaches the time of every command. Next we have the build option. So in build option, we have a set of options. Like we have a batch command. So this is for Windows. If you want to run some CMD commands to run test, if you want to run some shell commands or other options. So basically I am going to run shell command, which is this Python command, which I'm going to pass it. Next we have post build actions. So in post build action, basically what we can do is we can like do some git publish, or we can send mails, or even we can delete the workspace after the job completion, or like create the JUnit report. Whatever we want to do after executing the commands is come in the post build actions. So these are basically the options which we have in Jenkins. And in case of freestyle, you just have to click on everything and define those. So in pipeline, we do have same options, but we don't have to like click on them and define them. So how to create a pipeline? Basically, you go on new item, just put the name of the pipeline script, and instead of freestyle job, you have to select the pipeline option. Okay, and then in the configuration tab, so let us just create that pipeline script test PI. So instead of freestyle, we are going to select a pipeline job here. And as we move forward in pipeline job, we also have the same options. A few of them are like hide because we use them as code. So you can define here as well, like parameterize the project, but that doesn't make sense, right? Why we use freestyle in a pipeline instead of freestyle if we are going to click them on manually. So in pipeline job, we have this option in the last, this is called pipeline or the script. So here comes the script which you are going to use, the script of the job which actually going to run. So I do have that script as well. I have the script in the repo as well. You will get the repo URL in the end of presentation. So what I am going to do is I am running this pipeline script, putting this pipeline script right here, and run the job. So as the job get run, it will automatically set these parameters for you, which I just show in freestyle jobs. So let me clear a few things here. So this is going to be a pipeline job. So this is the syntax of writing pipeline job. So we have two syntax of writing pipeline job. One is a declarative syntax, and next is scripting syntax. So we are avoiding scripting syntax because that is not preferred by Jenkins now. Jenkins is saying that using declarative scripts is the best practice. So in declarative pipeline script, you have to define that I am going to use a pipeline, and then you have to define that this job is going to run on this agent. So what agent is here? So in Jenkins, what we can do is we can run different job on different machine as well. Currently, I have hosted my Jenkins on my local system, but you might add some other machines in the Jenkins as well. So those machines are called node, and different node have some label. So I am not using any other node. I am running it on my local host. So I just tell it that you have to run this job on a master node. Next, what I'm saying is, I am saying that you have to define two parameters, both are of string type, and the name of first parameter is users, and default value is user1, user2, and my username. Next, I am saying that you have to define another variable name password. Its default value is going to be password1, password2. Next, we come to the step. It has, in Jenkins, things work in form of stages. So we have multiple stages that are performing different tasks. In stages, we have steps. And in steps, we have like what we are going to perform. So we have two stages. So first stage is like clone the repo, which I have mentioned. Next step is to run the test, which is actual, which is the command Python con, which it is going to run. But if you notice that before running the Python command, I have tell Jenkins that you have to use this with credentials option. So this with credential is nothing which I just show you the secret text option, which we saw in the freestyle job. So what Jenkins is do is that it will look for this ID, that it will look in the Jenkins credential that is there something with ID FB. If there is that thing available, it will ask for another parameter called variable. So it will say that, hey, I got that FB ID thing, but how you are going to use it in the pipeline? So I say that I'm going to use that as pass. So in this case, you will see that I'm running the same script again, passing the dollar users. So what dollar user is whatever the default value of this variable, and what dollar password is like password one and password two. Next, I have tell that you have to run like add one more variable here, which is the actual password, the correct password of my Facebook account, that pass dollar pass. You have to use this as well. So let me just go to the repo, copy paste the same script and paste it in the Jenkins file right here. So as you can see, I have put it the thing here. So what Jenkins is do, first of all, it will go and look that is there any option defined here, as we have not defined any variable. So it will directly start running the job, and it will say that, okay, you are running it on master, you are defining two variables and doing these things. So I just apply these changes and open these pipeline job right here. And in the job, if you go to configure section, you will see the same thing which I just showed there. And we have a few options like deleting the job and renaming the job. So we have this option called build now. So this will actually start the pipeline to building. As I click on build now, you saw it started the first build. And as you click on the first build, it will say, like it will open the whatever things going with this build. So the status of the build, like pass, fail, or unstable, or aborted by someone. Changes is basically whatever you change in the pipeline or in the project repo which you just set, those changes are mentioned. And basically this is the git diff kind of thing. Next, the editing the build info, replay pipeline step. So we have this option called console output. In this section, we will actually see that what the pipeline is going to do. So the red symbol says that the job got failed. Let's see what happened. So the job started by the user. Okay. Next, it is running on the Jenkins master slave, and this is the workspace which I just show you that deleting the workspace thing. So let me go to my terminal and cd in this workspace. If I do a ls here, you can see that it has the Python file, the Jenkins file, which came here by cloning the repo. So it will delete this workspace before running job, if you select here that thing as well. So I do not specified any credentials to clone the repo. So it will, because this is a public repo, you don't need any credential. So it will clone the repo. Next, it will mask the $pass thing. It will mask my Facebook password and store them in a variable called $pass. But as it goes forward, it said that, dude, I didn't get anything property with the user. What you are going to do with user? So what actually happened is, when the job build the first time as I say that Jenkins will get that you, do you have defined anything? I didn't define anything. So it just keep going to the job. It will set the parameter and then it will clone the repo. And when it goes to this step that we are going dollar user. So Jenkins got stuck here that, dude, you haven't defined any variable and how you are going to use, I don't know what is dollar user. So as the job got built first time, now it has defined the variables. So if I close the tab and again go to the pipeline and go to the configuration section. So now you can see that the parameter is automatically defined by the pipeline script. It has the exact value which I given in the pipeline script. And password 1 and password 2. It doesn't show that secret text option here because that is being removed in freestyle job. Because we are using this with credentials option right here. So it pipeline script will remain same. So now it has defined the variables and everything is ready to go. I think this would get run this time and you can see that instead of build option, now we have build with parameter option here. So let's build again with pair parameters. As I click on the build, it will start the second trigger of that pipeline. Let us wait. So with three different username and three different password, I think it is a combination of like, I don't know how much it will take. Let's wait till the execute. So it will running the script, the Python script. I'm not doing anything. It will test that with user one with all the three password, password one, password two, and actual password which I passed using dollar pass. So user one with the second password, that is also like not the correct thing. So nothing is going to happen. Next, it will trigger for the user one with the actual original correct password which I have given there. So it is like opening the browser in here because it is running on localhost. If this thing is running on some another machine, for that thing we have a XVNC option in the Jenkins. So that will just keep opening the browser in the backend. This browser won't pop up. So it is trying the all the three password with user two. User two with the second password. It is wrong password, so it don't work. Now it will check with all the password with the, sorry, this is the third test with user two username. Now it will test with the actual username and all three, that two wrong password and my actual password which I have saved as encrypted thing in Jenkins. It has test that username with first password which is not correct. Next it will check the thing with the second password. It will check that is the login feature is working with the correct username and wrong password. It also doesn't work, so it close. Now it is going to pass the actual password which I have mentioned in Jenkins credential. This time it is going to use everything which is correct with correct username and correct password. And it is login. So we have tested that login feature that it is working perfectly with the correct username, incorrect password, and all the scenarios which we saw. So this job is like completed when it shows here. So this is how a job look when it trigger one or two or like 100 times, 1000 times. So here basically you will see that it's go turn into red if the job is fail, and it is passed in the first stage, which is cloning the repo, but it fails in the second step, which is actually running the test, because it doesn't get the user parameter in the first thing. Next, it will say that this much time has taken by the job to run the second stage or whatever it showing is just the information of the build. Now if we go to the console output, so it run the job run by user and on the master node and on this workspace, and nothing credential, just cloning the repo. This is the first stage, clone the repo. Next stage is to run the test cases, and the first case in the test case stage is with credentials, so it passed that password in the dollar pass. So as you saw the command which I have run, Python, the script Python file, the users which I have setted, the password which I set in the dollar password variable, the parameter section, this one, and with a comma I use that you have to specify this dollar pass as well. So this is the value of dollar pass. It doesn't display that because if multiple people are working and it will show the actual password, that's not the correction thing. So it has tested user with user 1 with all different password, user 2 with all different password, user 3 with all different password, and at the end of the job, this is the status of the job, like job got run successfully. So this is how the pipeline job works. So now if we get back to that slide where I have shown you that why we are going to use pipeline instead of freestyle. So first thing is no backup with freestyle job. If your Jenkins server got like damaged or something happened with your servers, it is deleted or whatever wrong thing happened with that, you do not have any backup of freestyle jobs. So that is the benefit with pipeline, that you have all your jobs stored in the repo. Next, easy to modify here. Easy to modify in the sense, suppose you have 50 or 60 jobs in your project and you have to change the version of your product. Suppose you have written all the 60 jobs which are running on x.y version of a product, and as the new release come, you have to change the version in all the 60 jobs. So that thing is very complicated with freestyle job. You have to click on every job, then you have to click on that set parameter option and change the value of the parameter, that version. But in case of pipeline job, you just have to go to the repo, change the parameter value in the repo, and that's it. The work is done. Easy maintenance means that easy maintenance, that's like in the case of easy maintenance, it is easy to maintain pipeline jobs as compared to freestyle job, because we have something called a seed job that will take care of like building all your pipeline things, and you don't have anything like this. Is basically similar to modify thing, but you will get to know about the maintenance thing when you use that thing in actual. But so a few questions which I want to cover is that this would be a problem that the parameters are not set in the first build, so we don't want that thing, right? So to prevent that thing, we have a ops we are using this parameter section right here. So instead of giving it parameter, you can write here definition. So that will, if you write definition instead of parameter here, that will set the parameter for you as well in the first build. So if you define, if you write definition instead of parameter, then Jenkins says that okay, he is defining these variables right now. So it will, if this is definition here, Jenkins will define that variable and it will go to the variable, so the job won't fail. Next thing which I want to discuss is that we do not use any post build actions here because we don't need them. I just go and delete that var file, everything is gone. So in the to use that post build actions, we have like we have agent, we have parameters, we have stages, we have something called post section. So that will take care of your post build actions. And if we move next in the presentation, so this is how the console URL looks. You have seen that the second stage is running the job. This is how the outlook of that thing, like time taken and whatever the information you need. And that's it from my side for this talk. There is a lot more thing which you can do with Jenkins, and this is just a short demo. So that's it. I'm up for questions now. Here's the repo URL which I used. You will get the PPT and the Python file and the Jenkins file in the repo. So I will paste the link in the meetup page. So yeah, that's it from my side. Up for the questions.
Thank you for the talk, Vipin. So there are one or two questions. I'm relaying those to you. Just give me a second. So Gautam says you can use the headless browsers as well.
So yeah, we can use that as well, but in this demo I prefer to use not the headless. I do not prefer to use headless mode because people can see what is going in the backend.
Right.
For this demo purpose, I just don't use the headless mode. In actual, we use the headless mode or the XVNC option, which I just mentioned. If you are using that option, you don't even know, you don't even need to set the headless command in your project. It will automatically create a virtual virtual pop-up for that Firefox, which you don't have to worry about.
Correct. So the next question is from Pooja. She's asking if next stage is dependent on output of previous stage, so how this can be achieved.
So what mean by dependency here in actual? So whatever task which is performed by step one, or suppose there are some file which is created by step one, or some variable which is setted by step one, stage one, sorry. So how we are going to use in actual step? That is what you mean?
Probably it can be anything, right? It can be output of a command, it can be output of some setting some variable or something like that.
Okay, so suppose you are setting some variable in the first stage and some file are created by some other files which we are going to use in next stage. So Jenkins do have a plugin as well, which will export or like define variable for you, or you can just use the export option of the cell. Suppose you are setting some variables, so you can just export them and use them in the next stage. Or what you can do is you can use the Groovy syntax of defining the variables. So you can just define a global variable using the Groovy syntax that can be used by another stage. And whatever files which you are going to use in the next stage, that are available in workspace only. So you can just pick that, you can pick them directly from the workspace.
So I would like to add to the answer, your answer, Vipin. We can use the variables. Second thing is you can use the env as well. So basically env is shared across all the stages.
Yes.
So if you just do env.myvar equal to some value, that will be available to next stages.
Yes, that env dot something is which I just mentioned, the Groovy syntax of using the variable.
Correct. And files are also available, as you said.
Yes.
And if you are running stages on different machines or slaves, there is also some construct which can help you to push the files, and the next node will pull the files again.
Yes. So there are a lot of plugins in Jenkins which you can use to perform your actions. And if there is not a plugin which you know how to do, so you are feel free to contribute.
I guess there are more questions. Let me check. So is there a new shell for every stage?
Yes, there is a new shell for every stage or every step. Even for every step, Jenkins create a new shell.
I think that's it for the questions.
Just want to add in that thing. So as you export a few things using the shell export, so they thing will get destroyed as you started the new shell. So the best option is to use that env option.
I guess let's wait for a few more seconds and then we can move forward.
Okay.
Okay, I guess those are the questions we had. Thank you so much for the great talk. It was nice to have insight into how pipelines work, why you should have pipelines and all. I'll personally also recommend everyone who are using the Jenkins jobs to explore the pipelines, as it will make your life easier and you can have your pipeline definitions or pipelines in the Git repo itself. Thank you so much, Vipin.
Okay, thanks.